My name is Casey Connor, and I would like to share a few words with this audience today. Everybody always asks me how I got into DJing, so I'm going to share that with you. I was 16 years old, from Brooklyn, New York, and I was living my dream. I was in performing arts high school. My classmates were Alicia Keys and Nicki Minaj, and I wanted to be the next Britney Spears. I got handed the worst news of my life. My mom was diagnosed with lung cancer. My sister was 12 years old at the time. I could either sink or swim. I decided to swim because that's what my mom would have wanted. I continued on to my senior year of high school. A year after my mom passed away, my dad had a massive heart attack and passed away. 1 year after my mom did. My sister was 13 years old, and on my 18th birthday, I got handed over guardianship of my sister. Always wanted to be a singer and dancer, always emulated Janet and Britney and Michael Jackson, and again, you know, losing your parents, it is the worst thing someone can possibly go through, especially when they're your best friend. Music was always in my heart, and I never wanted to stop that. I started DJing because a manager at the time that I was working with saw me dance and put me in a girl group with Puff Daddy. Long story short, I didn't have control. I wasn't able to write my own music. I wasn't able to perform. He took it upon himself to introduce me to Spinderella from Salt-N-Pepa. And I started to train with her and DJed and basically worked my way into a career of DJing for some of the biggest stars in Hollywood today, like Jennifer Lopez and Britney Spears and clients like Apple and so on and so forth. And the reason why I'm sharing this story today is because it's about being brave. There is no way that I can do what I do every single night, entertain thousands of people, if I wasn't raised by parents that taught me in the 16 and a half years that I had them, that nothing is impossible, and to follow your dreams, and to always be brave, and to never look back, and to continue to look forward. So again, my message is to everybody in this room is to continue to be brave. I like to play two songs that exemplify that, a song by Katy Perry named Roar, and another song called Brave. The only thing is I need everybody up out of their seats, joining me in a little dance party. Here we go. Feel free to sing along if you know the words. give it up for everybody in this room tonight. Give yourselves a big round of applause!